वेलकम माई व्यूअर्स वंस अगेन। आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग रीड पेपर 2021। टुडे आई वॉन्ट टू एक्सप्लेन यू रीड पेपर TGT लेवल 2, इट्स इंग्लिश पार्ट सेक्शन 3, विच वॉज कंडक्टेड इन द मॉर्निंग ऑफ 26 सेप्टेम्बर 2021 एट डिफरेंट सेंटर्स इन द स्टेट ऑफ राजस्थान। नाउ विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम let's come to question number 61. An elegy is - a joyful lyric, b a poem on the death of someone dear, c a sonnet on nature, and d a marriage song. So here b is the correct answer. An elegy is a poem which is written to mourn the death of a dear person. Okay, I want to tell you some important elegies which are very important for coming competitive exams. For example, Astrophel was written by Edmund Spenser on the death of Philip Sidney. Lycidas was written by John Milton on the death of King John. And Dionysus was written by P.B. Shelley on the death of Keats. And Tiresias was written by Matthew Arnold on the death of his friend A.H. Gluck. Okay, so you must know the publication of these important works. Okay, now question number 62. The speaker or the narrator in the pastoral elegy is a magician, b a shepherd, c a painter, and d a sculptor. So here in the pastoral elegy the speaker is a shepherd. Okay, always a shepherd. And John Milton's Lycidas is a pastoral elegy. Okay, and one more elegy that you must remember from examination point of view is elegy written in country churchyard, which was written by Thomas Gray in 1751. These are very important questions and can be asked in any competitive exam. Okay, marriage songs are also known as epithalamion, and one of the epithalamion was written by Spenser in about 1580s. Okay, a poem written to celebrate a marriage is called epithalamion. Okay, you must remember these questions. These are very important for TGT, PGT, and even NET. Question number 63. - is the rhyme scheme of the English sonnet. So here Shakespearean sonnet is popularly known as English sonnet, and its rhyme scheme is AB, AB, CD, CD, EF, EF, and GG. Okay, remember GG is always at the end of Shakespearean sonnet, and EE is always at the end of Spenserian sonnet. Okay, in addition to it, Miltonic sonnet is also there. You must know the rhyme scheme of Miltonic sonnet and sonnets, rhyme scheme of one more sonnet, Petrarchian sonnet is also there. Then question number 64. The drama that developed from religious rituals was classical drama, B, Elizabethan drama, C, medieval drama, and D, melodrama. So here, English drama has religious origin. It developed from mysteries and miracle plays. Okay, so here B is the correct answer. 65. Word is there, Berry. Okay, its pronunciation is given. Berry is the correct transcription of okay A, B, and C, and D. So here it is, it's the word will be B E double R Y. Okay, its pronunciation is Berry. Okay, like this. Okay, now here B is the right answer in 65. 66. Exist is transcribed as okay, its pronunciation is also written. Four options are given. Okay, here C is the correct answer. Okay, C is the correct answer. Now 67. The correct transcription of virtue is, okay, virtue is four pronunciations are given in four options. Here B is the right answer. Okay, B is the right answer. It will be written like this. Var, okay, ye girl wala a hai, okay, ch, एंड यू वर्चू. ओके वर्चू. देन क्वेश्चन नंबर 68, रेमेडियल क्लासेस प्ले एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल फॉर सोसाइटी. बी ब्राइट स्टूडेंट, सी डिजेबल वंस एंड डी इंटेलिजेंट वंस. ओके हियर सी इज द राइट आंसर. रेमेडियल क्लासेस आर फॉर वीक स्टूडेंट पर्टिकुलरली. ओके एंड डिजेबल वन आर ऑलवेज वीक. देन क्वेश्चन नंबर 69, एन इम्पॉर्टेंट फीचर ऑफ एन एडिक्वेट एवेल्युएशन इज. इट इज इनरिस्पॉन्सिबल. बी इट इज डायग्नोस्टिक, सी इट इन्हेंसेज लर्निंग एंड डी इट हराशिस स्टूडेंट. तो हेयर सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एवेल्युएशन ऑलवेज इन्हांसिस लर्निंग. देन 72, क्वेश्चन नंबर 72 आर बेस्ड ऑन सम लाइन्स. द विंड लाइज स्लीप इन द आर्म्स ऑफ द डॉन लाइक ए चाइल्ड दैट हैज क्राइड ऑल नाइट. ओके हियर थ्री क्वेश्चंस आर देयर. द सेकंड लाइन इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ. ओके सेकंड लाइन इज लाइक ए चाइल्ड दैट हैज क्राइड ऑल नाइट. ओके हियर लाइक वर्ड इज देयर सो आंसर विल बी सिमिली. ओके देन 71, मेटाफर इज डिफाइंड एज फार फेच्ड सिमिली. बी इम्प्लाइड सिमली, सी कॉन्वर्ट सिमली एंड डी एक्सप्लिसिट सिमली. तो मेटाफर इज ऑलवेज एन इम्प्लाइड सिमली. ओके विदाउट द यूज ऑफ एज और लाइक. ओके लाइफ इज ए वॉकिंग शेडो इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ मेटाफर. देन 72 is an example of personification in the above line. Okay, wind is an example of personification in the above line. Here A is the right answer. Then question number 73, blank verse is iambic pentameter. Okay, four options are given. Without rhyme, now without rhyme, then with rhyme, then with alternate rhyme and without alternate rhyme. Okay, so here without rhyme A will be the right answer. Blank verse are five stressed syllable in iambic pentameter lines which don't rhyme together, and if they are rhyming then they are called couplets also. Then 74, oh west wind, oh wild west wind, thou breath of autumn being. Okay, this is from John Keats' famous poem Ode to West Wind. Okay, now the above line contains figures of speech are there, personification and alliteration, simile and alliteration, personification and simile, and D is metaphor and personification. So here alliteration is there. Okay, W sound is there. Okay, W sound is there, and then personification is there. Okay, oh these lines are addressed to west wind, so west wind is addressed as if it is Allah, it is a living being. Okay, and personification is also known as apostrophe. Okay, apostrophe is a figure of speech in which abstract ideas or inanimate objects are addressed as if they are alive. So here A is the right answer. Now 75 question, dash I was no better than a dead man. I was alive and was able to reach the shore. Okay, so here you have to fill a conjunction. Okay, four conjunctions are there. Student, I want to tell you that I have already made 15 videos on parts of speech, noun, pronoun, adjective, adverb, verb, conjunction, interjunction and preposition. If you have not watched these videos and if you want to prepare for competitive examinations, watch these videos on my YouTube channel Easy English NCRT e-learning with Chandrapal. If you have not subscribed it, subscribe it. Okay, for your coming videos I am going to make a lot of videos for you in the coming days. So here A option, though. Okay, though and although have same meaning. Okay, though I was no better than a dead man, I was alive and was able to reach the shore. हालांकि मैं एक मरे हुए व्यक्ति की तरह से था, फिर भी मैं किनारे तक पहुंच गया. आगे आपका है क्वेश्चन 77, मिजल्स. ओके मिजल्स इज नेम ऑफ ए डिजीज. ओके एन इफेक्टियस डिजीज, तो मिजल इज आएगा. ओके ये सब्जेक्ट वर्ब एग्रीमेंट का क्वेश्चन है, इसके ऊपर भी मैं वीडियो बना चुका हूँ, आप उस वीडियो को देख सकते हो, सब्जेक्ट वर्ब एग्रीमेंट की वीडियो को प्लेलिस्ट के अंदर जा करके. देन 77, माई फ्रेंड एंड माई फादर, माई फ्रेंड एंड हिज फादर डैश मीटिंग अस टुमारो. तो हेयर व्हेन टू सब्जेक्ट्स आर ज्वाइंड बाय कंजंक्शन एंड देन वी ऑलवेज यूज प्लूरल वर्ब. ओके हेयर आर इज करेक्ट, माई फ्रेंड एंड हिज फादर आर मीटिंग अस टुमारो, माई फ्रेंड एंड हिज फादर आर मीटिंग अस टुमारो. 78, द फिशरमैन कास्ट हिज नेट फॉर टू होल डेज बट, ओके बट डैश नॉट गेट ए गुड लॉट. ओके ए कैन बी माइट सी कुड एंड डी मे, तो हेयर सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर, बट कुड नॉट गेट ए गुड लॉट. देन क्वेश्चन नंबर 79, रवि's अंकल गाइडेड हिम हाउ ही शुड अटेम्प्ट हिज टेस्ट. ओके हेयर बी इज द राइट आंसर, बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर शुड. क्वेश्चन नंबर 80th, flying in the face of dash means respect, pray, okay, reward or insult. Okay, here spelling of pray is given wrong, P-R-E-Y is the right word. Okay, here D is the right answer, flying in the face of means insulting someone, D is the right answer. Then 21 question, by fits and starts means, okay, this is an idiom and it is from CBSE class book. Okay, CBSE class 10th book, Footprints Without Feet. In it, there is a story, the thief story, and from the thief story, this question is there. Fits and starts mean, okay, not regular. Okay, C option is the correct answer. So here in this book, the line is, Anil earned money by fits and starts. Okay, C is the right answer. Now question number 82 and 83 are based on small paragraph. Watching television for a long time could lower academic performance. It steals away the reading time. Time management is about self-discipline. Time must be managed between filled and unfilled time. Okay, 82 question. May be an appropriate title for the given extract. Okay, extract means paragraph होता है. A discipline, B self-respect, C time management and D television. Here C is the correct answer. His father never starved but he could not cast any doubt on his story. So he had to make an effort to hold his tongue. Okay, in this question 83, the linking device, okay, used in the above extract belong to a concession and contrast. Okay, linking device here, underline word or conjunction. Okay, conjunctions are those words which join either two words, two phrases or two sentences. Okay, but and so both are conjunctions here, and options are given, concession and contrast, B opinion and purpose, C condition and adding ideas, and D is contrast and consequence. So here but is used as contrast and so is used as consequence. Okay, conjunction of consequence. Okay, D is the right answer. Then adjust is transcribed as phonetic transcription is given. Okay, A B C and D. Okay, I want to write its right transcription. Okay, it will be written like this. Okay, small a will be there, then adjust. Okay, adjust, it will be written like this. Okay, and stress will be here, adjust. A is the right answer. Then yes, 85th question is based on phonetics. Velar is the sound formed by, okay, the front of the tongue and hard palate. Okay, B is the lower lip and the upper teeth, C the blade of the tongue and teeth ridge, and D the back of the tongue and soft palate. Okay, so here D is the right answer. Actually, velar sound is a sound which is pronounced with the back of the tongue and soft palate. Okay, when back of the tongue and soft palate come close to each other, then we produce three velar sounds. Okay, ka, ga and semi vowel, जो W से लिखा जाता है. Okay, I want to write it. Ka, ga and okay, this vowel. Okay, these are velar sound. Then question number 86. Again, question on phonetics is there. Sounds, okay, sa, va, tha, ra, etc. are, okay, example, semi-vowels, lateral vowels, fricatives, or nasals. Okay, nasal sounds are three. Okay, always remember, ma, na, and zoom. Okay, at the end of king, like this. Then, semi-vowels are two. Okay, two semi-vowels are there. Okay, two semi-vowels are there, remember, okay, this and this semi-vowels are there, and rest of sounds which are given, which is the right answer, I don't want to go into detail. Okay, these are fricatives. Fricatives are nine sounds, okay, and these fricatives are those sounds when the active articulator is brought so close to the passive articulator that the passage between them is very, very narrow and the air passes through it with audible friction. Okay, students, I have added just a small picture at the end of the video based on phonetics, and I have added the title of the book that you must read for preparation of phonetics, okay, accurately and in detail. The name of the book is A Course of Phonetics, written by C.T. and Damija. Picture is there at the end of the video. You can take a screenshot of it. And moreover, I have recommended one more book to you for the preparation of these type of TGT, PGT and NET examination. Okay, name of the book is given at the end. Okay, M.H. Abraham, A Glossary of Literary Terms. You should buy these books because these are very, very important. Without these books, you cannot succeed in your examination. Now, question number 87. Which of the following plays the basic role is learner, basic role in learning a mother tongue played? Okay, which of the following plays the basic role in learning a mother tongue? Motivation, naturalness, habit formation, and D is purpose. So here C is the right answer, habit formation. Okay, some examiner may give its answer naturalness also, but according to me, habit formation is the right answer. 88. Dash is one of the chief characteristics of communicative approach. A, examples are given to make the things clear. B, it does not need trained teacher. C, learner learns the target language as mother tongue. And D is textbooks plays an important role. Okay, in the communicative approach, C is the right answer. Learner learns the target language as mother tongue. Okay, now second last question. Linguistic variability or multilingualism is a dash to acquire the knowledge of a foreign language. बून, ओके, बून क्या होता है, वरदान होता है. ओके, बी इज हार्डशिप, सी इज टूल एंड डी इज लैडर. ओके, लैडर सीडी को बोलते हैं. तो हेयर सी इज द राइट आंसर. लिंग्विस्टिक वेरिएबिलिटी और मल्टी लैंग्वेजिज्म इज ए टूल टू अक्वायर द नॉलेज ऑफ ए फॉरेन लैंग्वेज. एंड लास्ट क्वेश्चन, द बेसिक रेमिडियल इंग्लिश मे कवर वोकैबुलरी, B, reading comprehension, C, both A and B, and D, none of these. So here C is the right answer. Remedial classes should be to improve the vocabulary and reading comprehension of the student. So student, this is all about your level 1 read, level 1 and level 2 examination. I have tried my best to cover your paper and improve your studies. Okay, you can watch the screen. Okay, on the screen, I have recommended you two books, one on phonetics and one on terminology of literature. Okay, glossary of literature. and one more photograph is there for how the sounds are produced. Okay, 44 sounds of English language they are produced and where they are produced. Okay, sound are produced in plosive manner. Okay, then affricates, nasal, lateral, fricative and frictionless continent, semi vowels are there, and then their place of articulation is there, bilabial, labiodental, dental, alveolar, post alveolar, then velar and glottis. All these you must know. A picture, complete picture I have given you, for you can take its screenshot for remembering them. This is all about your REET examination. And I am also going to make some more videos on competitive examinations, okay, PGT and NET also. Very soon you will see these videos on my channel. Thank you so much. Okay, till then we meet next. Thank you so much.